Welcome to this short tutorial on network tools. And these are tools we are using in the i2connect project. The i2connect project is about interactive innovation. And interactive innovation is about co-creation, with the assumption that if you create the solutions together, the quality will be better for everyone. We talk about operational groups, we talk about innovation processes, but actually I like more the term network for the whole collection of actors that are involved in the development of something new. So actually all these tools apply to all these kind of networks. What we try to do is equip advisors with ideas and tools to assist groups, operational groups, farmers groups who are working this way. And with these tools, you can reflect on any moment what's going on here and what could be my next step. Now, in this video, I want to present to you a short overview of four different tools we are usually utilizing. And each tool actually is a different window through which you can look at reality. So you look at different aspects of what's going on in your network. Now the first tool I would like to present to you is the spiral of innovations. We also call it the spiral of initiatives because it is really about the initiative that develops further and further. On the road from the first idea until many people applying this new idea, this new technique, this new way of organizing things, you will pass by a number of stages. And what this model does is, on any moment you can see, hey, in what stage we are now, what needs to happen here, and how do we get from here to the next stage? And sometimes you will discover that the best thing to do is going back to an earlier stage. So it is not a linear model, it is a spiral. Because innovation is not just a straight process. You will encounter all kinds of surprises and you have to deal with it. So this model helps you to see what needs to happen here, who do we have to involve, and how do we get further. Now the next model I would like to talk about is the network analysis. If you see innovation as a growing network, then it becomes interesting to see which actors are involved. So this model helps you to see if you have thought of the most important actors for the whole process. And many times these actors cannot be accessed immediately. For example, you cannot reach all farmers at the same time or all consumers at the same time. So then the next question comes, who can link you with the actors involved? So who could be intermediaries? With whom do you have contact? So what is feasible to do as the next step? The next model is the circle of coherence. This is the most complex one, but also the deepest one. And this is all about the energy I was talking about. And the energy you feel in what I call the vital space. And in this vital space, people feel useful. They want to engage. They want to contribute. They feel safe enough to make mistakes, to learn. And that is what you want. But it is not just given. You can do something for it. And it shows you four different quadrants of interaction. And in each quadrant, you need to do something different. And making that a distinction helps you to know what to do to get into this vital space. And then I would like to talk about the triangle of co-creation. In any process, in any network, people take different positions. Some positions are contributing to co-creation and others are not contributing. Now, reflecting on what position people take and what might be needed to get them into a position that is really contributing, that is what this triangle of co-creation is all about. For example, you need people who really pull the initiative forward. You need other people who take a management position in which they create the possibilities in which it can happen. And you need people who really give it the hands and the feet to move it forward, maybe to bring in their expertise. But before you have people in these contributing positions, sometimes something needs to happen. And in our experience, you need a free actor, someone who is free enough in his mind and in his possibilities to create the connections that are necessary and to make people reflect on their own role and maybe change their role. This was a short overview of the tools we use in i2connect, some of the tools we use in i2connect. For each method, we made a separate video you can check. If you want to know more, there's also the i2connect website on which you can find the toolbox portal. And if you are really interested, you can also read my book, Energizing Networks.